Hi, everybody, and welcome to Visual Rhetoric Online. This is WRTC 351, and I'm Pavel Zemlyansky, your instructor for this class. Some of you may know me from face-to-face classes at WRTC. But if you've never taken an online class before, you're probably wondering how online classes would work and what the differences might be between a face-to-face course and an online course. So in this video, I'd like to introduce the class a little bit to you and also outline some of the similarities and differences between face-to-face and online courses, and also outline the class itself and let you know what to expect. First of all, the basics really of face-to-face and online learning are pretty much the same. You do readings, you do assignments, you have deadlines to follow, you have to post stuff on the website, and you have to communicate with your instructor and your classmates as well. So this is where the similarities pretty much end. The differences are quite substantial. First of all, because it's a summer class, it's very compressed. In 6 weeks, we have to do pretty much what we would normally do in 15 or 16 weeks during a regular semester. And we'll also do this work online. Now, what this means is that we won't actually be seeing each other face-to-face, obviously, but we will be communicating a lot on the website through discussion forum posts, assignments, comments for one another, and so on and so forth. So one of the main challenges and difficulties when teaching online or taking an online course is not to feel that you've been abandoned by the rest of the group, not to feel that sense of separation, sense of loneliness, I guess, in a way, that some online classes that are not designed very well can give participants. So the first challenge that we face as a group is to create a sense of community, a sense of belonging, a sense of a group that we would normally have in a face-to-face class where we talk to one another quite a lot and communicate and interact. So establishing that interactivity is certainly one of the big challenges and one of the important tasks of this class. And to do that, we'll, as I said, use everything that we have at our disposal, such as discussion forums, email to a little bit of a lesser extent. And plus, I will be recording these little online videos and posting them in the beginning of each week to give you a sense that I'm not just a person behind a keyboard. All right, so if you look at the class website, you will see that you know, the usual structure of the website. It has a syllabus, it has a calendar, it has a description of the assignments, it has a discussion forum section, and it's got a contact page. So there shouldn't be really any surprises here, but I would like to point out what the format of the projects for this class is. The class lasts 6 weeks, and I've divided the 6 weeks into three learning modules of 2 weeks each. You can find the descriptions of each module and each project associated with those modules in the Learning Modules page of the on the site. The first module, which will last 2 weeks, will have to do with fundamentals and foundations of visual rhetoric. It's very heavily front-loaded with readings and discussion posts on the forums, so expect to do a lot of reading and a lot of writing in the forums during the first couple of weeks of the course. And also expect to comment on one another's posts in writing on those forums as well. During the second learning module, which lasts also 2 weeks, weeks 3 and 4 of the class, we will begin working on the first creative project, I would say, the photo essay with captions. You will see, when you read the descriptions of the projects on the learning modules page, you will see that I'd like the second and the third modules to be kind of connected with one another. And so the photo essay project is the first half of that connection that I'd like you to create. And then in the third learning module, weeks 5 and 6, we'll work on the second visual project, and that would be a short video project, and also accompanied by a little introductory essay, which will connect the photo essay and the video project. Again, this might sound a little confusing in the video, so take a look at the learning projects, learning modules page, and let me know if you have any questions about those. I'm sure there will be some questions. So, and then, of course, the online participation and what I would call the online presence in the class is a very important component of this course, and that's 40% of your course grade. So you can read more specific descriptions of that requirement and what that entails on Nicola's website, and let me know if you have any questions as well about that. Learning online, taking online classes, is a pretty exciting possibility. And I'm not sure where you guys are located geographically for this class, but obviously one of the advantages is that you could be anywhere in the world, literally, and take this class. You don't have to be on campus. So as much as possible, I have tried to take that into account when designing assignments for this class. And you will see in the Learning Modules page that I'm actually encouraging you to use the location where you're at, whether you're in Harrisonburg or somewhere else, doesn't really matter, to create your visual text and think about visuals in this class. Again, I look forward to you joining me in this course, and if you have any questions about anything, please let me know. If you have any technical problems, there is an FAQ forum in the forums. You can post those questions there. And I look forward to working with you. And again, thank you very much, and have a great day.